Speak. All prayers are heard, not all are acknowledged. Every small cog drives a greater gear. Each is necessary, otherwise the whole collapses. When any cog shivers from the stresses on it, the master feels it, but the load he assigns it is no more than he knows it can bear. Wizard, mystic, master of the Clockwork City. An architect of time and a binder of oblivion. One who masters the tools that mastered others.
What do you want?
I can feel the blessings upon you. It's a power I've not felt myself for many... I see. I hadn't considered there might be threats more grave than the Covenant invasion. You would think, given all we know of the treachery of Cold Harbor, that I would see that. What of Sotha Seal? I am ashamed. The three have shown more faith in me than I have in them. I dread asking this, but what of Lord Vivek? Ha! Yes, I should have known. Vivek is the most subtle of the three. It's true, I've been counseling a Dunmer who questions his faith. He told me the Tribunal are losing their powers. Only indirectly. We see the three less every year. They no longer make their annual pilgrimage to Red Mountain on Vardenfell, and no one knows why. It all seems so convincing when he said it. His name is Ravil Urano. He hasn't come to pray for days now. He was in such despair, I think he'd even stopped bathing. The last time I saw him, he smelled terrible, like fresh offal. What? Have I been a fool? I questioned my faith for the flimsiest of reasons and caused others to question theirs. I have much to do to correct my failure. I wish I knew why Ravil Urano...
Have our town's fortunes improved? That's a great relief. Well done. The Covenant troops haven't left their encampment to the west, but it's only a matter of time before our inactivity encourages them. I don't know this, Myr. Why would he cause so much trouble? Perhaps he's an agent of Sheer Gorath. That's an unpleasant thought. The Daedra of Chaos is worse than any mere Covenant army. Can you aid me further? Ravil must have a house in town. I'd like you to find it and watch him. I'd like to see myself, but I'm sure he'll recognize me. Commoners would call it a scrying spell, but I'm beyond such crude hedge magic. It will enable me to see and hear what you do. Furthermore, search for Ravil's home.
You should be able to hear me now. Let's follow him.
Hey, Ravil! No offal today. The temple's forbidden all sales.
Quiet, fool. I paid you for your discretion, remember?
That fancy sod was in our camp. Hey, fancy man. Fallen on any swords lately? Saying we shouldn't help the Dunmer? Like a Nord would ever turn down a fight.
drunk one took your advice, Silvertongue. He now regrets it. For shame.
It was just idle talk, friend. I assure you, I had nothing to do with it.
You went into that shack. Wait for him to leave. He's out. That was fast. Try to get inside that shack. A communication spell. Let's see who Ravil called.
What now, Ravil? So you're the meddler who undid all of Ravil's work. Such a waste of my time.
That woman wore a Covenant uniform. Ravil! Go to his house and see what you can find. I'll send my guards.
What are you doing here?
You won't take me! Cornell gave me potions!
The guards heard fighting. I assume you found more inside than just evidence? Having him alive might have been useful, but having him dead is just as good. The ritual items in the shack on the docks and his belongings might tell us something more.
I'm only a merchant until my poetry can.
Arthur's told everyone who would listen how you discovered that spy. friend. A moment of your time. Honor to you and your house, traveler. Say, you look... Stone Falls is under attack, and some of the finer things in life are suddenly precious. Certain goods can be very lucrative when paired with the right buyer. Take... Steal? Such an ugly word. Procure. I'd like you to procure a single precious bottle of White Gold Tower. A former war wizard has it now. Just replace her bottle with this identical bottle filled with cheap rotgut. We'll both profit. Just let me know what I can do to help. She used to serve in the Morrowind Army as a war wizard. I think the explosions were too much for her. After she retired from service, she opened the ebony flask with Darvi Nilsson. Not exactly, but then again, that's your side of this business, isn't it? My only advice is to talk to the Nightflowers at the inn. Just let me know what I can do.
There is an urgent task for you. Shall I dance for you, my lord? I've studied under many masters of the art. I'm sure I could hold your attention. For hours. Lady Fedrosa. I don't care for her, actually, but the money here at the Ebony Flask is good. If it wasn't, Amelia and I would have cleared out long ago. She's just too jumpy. They say the Argaviri War made her twitchy. She's easily startled by the strangest things, like lizards. Those lizards infesting the Argurian Quarter drive her crazy.
Will you be staying in Ebonheart long, Serio? I'm sure we could make your stay more pleasant. I don't hate her, but there's no love lost between the Nightflowers and Fedrosa. She regards us a necessary evil. She doesn't even partake of our town. My guess is she's caught one too many fireball blasts in the war. She still hates loud noises. There's an alchemist next door who's constantly testing flash powder and sulfurs.
Can I help you?
You have a look about you. Some sort of quality that's rare to find. And trust me, I'm never wrong about these sort of things. Can I look, empty rooms are just bad for business. I need someone to improve the reputation of my property. Such a cozy little home.
The guild has need of you, comrade.